In the last video, we established that the operator that we use inside of our WHERE clause is going to influence the type of data or the structure of data that we have to return from our subquery. Let's take a look at a table that's going to summarize what operator we're going to use with the different type of data coming back. All right, here we go. So this table looks a little bit confusing. There's a lot of information in it. Let me give you a couple of quick notes. So on the left-hand column on both sides, if you use the shown operator or the provided operator right here inside the WHERE clause, that means that your subquery that is also inside the WHERE clause must return this structure of data. So in other words, if we use a greater than operator inside of WHERE, our subquery must return a single value. If we make use of the IN operator, then our subquery must return a single column. If we make use of equal, we must do a single value, and so on. Now on the right-hand side, you'll notice that some of these values look really confusing right here. I'll give you some more information on these in just a moment. Right now, we're just going to ignore them. Last thing I want to mention is that I know there's a lot of information here, and you might be tempted to print this out or just try to memorize all this stuff. I really think that you don't need to try to memorize this. I think you're going to realize rather quickly that a lot of the information in here or a lot of these different rules are actually going to end up being kind of rather obvious once you've gone through a couple of different queries. So with that in mind, let's try to write out another query right now where we will make use of a subquery inside of the WHERE clause. As we write the query out, we're going to come back over to this table and we're going to reference and figure out exactly what the structure of data coming back from our subquery must be depending upon the operator that we use. All right, so here's what we're going to try to solve. We're going to take a look at our products table. Our goal is to show the name of all products that have a price greater than the average product price. So to solve this, we're definitely going to need to make use of a subquery. The goal of the subquery is to figure out the second part right here, the average product price. That's what we're going to implement with the subquery. Before we worry about the subquery too much, however, let's just focus on what operator we should probably use inside of the WHERE clause. Once we figure out which operator we should use, we can then figure out the structure of data that needs to come back from the subquery. So in this case, it says very clearly that we want to find products with a price greater than this stuff. So the term in here, the keyword is greater than. That is a sign that we probably want to find where the price is greater than something. So our operator in this case is going to be a greater than sign. Now that we've established that, let's go figure out the structure of data that must come back from our subquery. Okay, here's greater than. So this table is telling us that if we are going to implement a subquery, it must return a single value. And that's pretty much it. That's how we would use this table. All right, so with that in mind, let's now try to write out a subquery that's going to return a single value right here. And as you guess, the goal is to return just the average product price. That's what we want to return. Well, to do this, let's go back over and write out a quick query. So to find the average price out of all of our different products, we might write something like select average of price from products. I'm then going to run that, and I get back a result of 498. Now that definitely looks pretty accurate to me because I randomly generated all this data, and all the different prices range from around 1 to 1,000 or so. So an average price of around 498 sounds pretty much right. The other thing you'll notice here is that we are getting back a single value because we have one row and one column. So this can serve as our subquery. We would take that and put that right here. So select average price from products. All right. Probably don't care about the formatting there too much. Well, now that we understand these two parts, we can assemble them together into one big query. So I'm going to go back over. I'm going to start from scratch. I'm going to select just the name from products. And I want to find only the products where the price is greater than. I'm going to put in my parentheses for a subquery. And we'll do a select average price from products. Products. There we go. Okay, so let's run this. And looks good to me, more or less. I'm not entirely sure if this is the correct answer, but I think the query is definitely right. So I think this is probably the correct result. The only reason I say that is it's kind of hard for us to actually verify this is the correct data. We might try to print out the price of each of these as well, and then just verify that all the different prices listed are greater than that average price of $4.98. And looking at these, yep, definitely looks like that is the case. All right, so we have now established that we have some subqueries that are going to return a single column when we are using them inside the where clause. And we just saw one where we have a subquery returning a single value. And again, it all comes down to which operator we are trying to use. So let's take a look at another example of this in the next video.